Good evening. I'm Dr. Vishnu Harika, second year post graduate from the Department of Radio Diagnosis, Shantiram Medical College, Nandyal. Today, my paper presentation topic is computed tomographic evaluation of mediastinal masses. Coming to introduction, mediastinal masses represent wide diversity of disease state. The clinical spectrum of mediastinal masses can range from asymptomatic to producing compressive symptoms. Mediastinal masses span a wide histopathological and radiological spectrum. Location and composition of a mass is critical in narrowing the differential diagnosis. Computed tomography is the most important tool in the evaluation of mediastinal mass in determining the exact location as well as its relationship to adjacent structures. Characterization on CT is based on specific attenuation of soft tissue, fat, water, and calcium. High-resolution multiplanar deformation images display the detailed anatomic relationship of the tumor with adjacent structures. Aims and objectives: to study the distribution of mediastinal masses, to study the computed tomographic evaluation of the mediastinal masses, to study the involvement of neighboring structures and associated findings in mediastinal masses, to compare the CT findings with pathologic findings wherever possible. Materials and methods. Source of data is the patients from Shantaram Medical College, Nandyal. Method of collection of data. All patients referred from the departments of medicine, surgery, pediatrics, and chest disease to the department of radio diagnosis with a clinical suspicion of mediastinal mass or who had an abnormal chest radiograph suggestive of mediastinal mass. Sample size includes 50 patients. Study period is over a period of 10 months from January 2021 to October 2021. Type of study is prospective study design. Inclusion criteria. CT study of mediastinum is conducted in clinically suspected cases of mediastinal mass or lesion. Patients where the chest radiograph showed the mediastinal mass. Exclusion criteria are the cardiac cases and traumatic cases. Coming to results and analysis. In the present study where 50 patients were studied, mediastinal masses were more common in men who presented more commonly in 5th to 6th decade of life. Females more commonly presented in 3rd to 4th decade of life. This is the table showing the age distribution of mediastinal masses where we can see in the 21 to 40 years age group, majority of the cases have been occurred, followed by the age group of 41 to 60 years. Table 2 shows the clinical presentation of mediastinal masses where we can see the cough is the major presenting complaint seen in approximately 70% of the cases. This is the table showing the localization of mediastinal masses, where we can see the occurrence of lesions more commonly in the anterior mediastinum, followed by posterior mediastinum and middle mediastinum. This is the table showing plane study attenuation of mediastinal masses, where we can see soft tissue attenuation in 34 cases. Cystic attenuation in 23 cases. Calcifications are seen in 22 cases. Fat is seen in 2 cases. This is the table showing contrast enhancement pattern of the mediastinal masses. Homogeneous enhancement is seen in 11 cases. Heterogeneous enhancement is seen in 22 cases. Rim enhancement is seen in 7 cases. Intense enhancement is seen in 10 cases. This is the table showing the associated findings in mediastinal masses, where the involvement of adjacent structures is seen in 24 cases, lump findings are noted in 32 cases, bone involvement is seen in 7 cases. These are the images in a 62 years old male with cough and breathlessness showing opacification of left hemithorax on the radiograph. Contrast and axial and coronal reformated images showing intensely enhancing large aortic aneurysm with non-enhancing thrombus within. Aneurysm is compressing the left main bronchus, resulting in collapse of the left lung. Moderate left pleural effusion is also noted. This sagittal reformated image in bone window shows erosion of the vertebral body by the long-standing aneurysm. These are the images in a 44-year-old patient with cough and breathlessness, showing soft tissue density mass with speckles of calcification in the anterior mediastinum. Heterogeneous enhancement of the mass is noted on contrast study. CT-guided biopsy of mass proved to be invasive thymoma on histopathology. These are the images in a 36-year-old female showing round homogeneous opacity in the left hemithorax. We can see the blunting of left costophrenic angle. Axial MECT and contrast enhanced images show heterogeneously enhancing mass in the posterior mediastinum, and we can see the left pleural effusion. On histopathology, it is proved to be schwannoma. Discussion: mediastinal masses represent a wide diversity of disease state. Clinical spectrum of mediastinal masses can range from being asymptomatic to producing compressive symptoms. Location and composition of mass is critical in narrowing differential diagnosis. Although many of these masses have similar imaging appearances, clinical history, anatomical position, and certain details seen at imaging allow correct diagnosis in many cases. Although chest radiography is used in the initial detection of mediastinal mass, their further evaluation needs CT. The present study, mediastinal masses were more commonly encountered between 3rd to 6th decade of life with male preponderance. Conclusion: CT plays an important role in evaluation of mediastinal masses in terms of their distribution, their further characterization and distinguishing benign and malignant lesions. CT gives clear delineation of lesions and distinguishes them better from normal structures. To conclude, CT is the imaging modality of choice in evaluating mediastinal mass. For their exact localization, studying the morphological features and arriving at a provisional diagnosis for optimal patient management. These are the provisional list of references. Thank you.